Donda, 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 you see Georgi?
No.
Where is Georgi? Nuribe, Nuribe, Georgi. The Statue of Liberty. How are you? Georgi Birjantzis Hekele? Talk English. I learn.
All right. First thing you learn, to Statue of Liberty, you don't say, how are you? To people, you say, how are you? To Statue, you say, he's pretty, he's beautiful. Not, how are you? Now we got to hurry, so we'll be first ones off boat. Because downstairs, the immigration officer, show passport.
87, 87, 87.
Será?
O tu? How are you?
I'm fine. How are you? Where's your landing card?
He does not speak much English. Just how are you? He's from Kartli, part of Georgia.
Thanks. I'll get a Russian interpreter. Say, John.
Won't do no good. He does not speak Russian. His language in Russian is same as Chinese and English. It's very different. Not only language, but music, people, everything.
Do you understand him?
If he speaks Kartli, no. When he speaks Turkish, yes. He lived many years in Turkey. I meet him there. I speak for him.
Do you... What's the matter with him?
He's very worried to be stranger in strange land. And not to speak language, he's afraid people will not make welcome. With me, it's different. I came in America when I'm small boy, stay here 5 months, 3 days, know USA very well. George...
Wait a minute. Tell him as long as he has this passport, you are welcome. Welcome. Tell him the only thing to remember is that we are all foreigners here. The only difference is some came early, some came late. You know something? Right now, at this moment, you are the very latest. Congratulations.
Passport Rodutska, Hershey Yulundo, Chekina Chek, Birseyo.
How are you?
My friend very much wants to find his Uncle John. You ever see such person? His menu from his restaurant.
I'm sorry, I've never seen him. This is from 1936. Hasn't he heard from him since?
No, Uncle John, not able to write. Just send menu.
Sorry, I can't help you.
Bill me all. Don't worry, we find him later. First we go to hotel. Then I help him find his Uncle John.
Thank you.
Δημήτριος, έλα εδώ. Γιατί δεν μπορώ να μαγειρέψω στο δωμάτιο?
Γιατί δεν επιτρέπεται η μαγειρική, διάβασε.
Πολύ καλά. Αύριο φεύγω, έχω δουλειά με τον Σπύρο Σκούρας.
Say nothing. I do all the talk. I get us good outdoor job. Plenty fresh air. English, you must watch your speaking in mirror. Come here. Now, say a speech I give you to practice on yesterday. I wish I were a witch with violet velvet woolies. Now try.
I wish I were a witch with violet velvet woolies.
Georgi, there is one rule for Georgians, Turks, Armenians when learning English. Whenever you think should say V, say W. When you think should be W, say V. That way can't go wrong. Now try again.
I wish I were a witch with violet velvet woolies. I wish I were a witch with violet velvet. Velvet woolies. I wish I were.
Wish
I were. I were a witch with violet velvet woolies. I wish I were a witch with violet velvet woolies. I wish I were a witch. I wish I were a witch with violet velvet woolies. I wish I were a witch with violet velvet woolies.
Georgi?
This was very good. Very, very
good. Perfect. You have learned English very fast. We now go to Central Park and look for Uncle John again.
Today, I think I find him.
Uncle
Nuremberg. Hey, Nuremberg, come here, look. They are beautiful. Look what they're doing. Petras. Petras, wait. Wait, Petras, stop.
Here, they are big ones.
Petras, stop it. Why are you doing
that? I take bouquet to lady friend.
Where you got lady friend?
If I bouquet, maybe I'll find.
Possible. Good idea. Wait, why spoil? Better than take three to lady friend is bring lady friend to three. This way, get to work with her at same time.
Pink like cheek of beautiful lady. Never saw so beautiful.
There are bigger ones over there.
Here we go again.
Lobby and hotel.
Look at this, how big. I get that.
This is awful thing. It's very awful thing.
It's nothing.
Pay little fines is nothing.
It's nothing?
I am first man from Kobyankari ever come to USA. Then for what? For go prison.
Just plead guilty and send money.
But I am not guilty.
You've got to speak to you from heart, like friend. If it's one thing I know, is law. You say you're not guilty, you have to go in court. Then you lose day's pay. So you say you're guilty. It's cheaper.
It's cheaper, too, to shoot out brains. No clothes to buy, no food, no hotel room to pay. Only one trouble. You're no longer a man.
There's only one thing to do. We go see Fixer.
Fixer? What means Fixer?
This man who fixes things. You pay, he tears up summons, tickets from traffic, all kinds of things. Come, we see Fixer.
In addition to my fee of $5, I'll need $2 for the fines. Well? What about you?
I'm not guilty. I don't pay.
What happens if he goes in court?
That depends on the judge. In civic property cases, some judges can be awful mean. Awful mean.
Flower picking on the lawn adjacent to the Wallman Memorial in Central Park. Before pleading these charges, you have the right to ask for an adjournment in order to obtain counsel or witnesses. How do you plead?
The defendant has heard the charges. How does he plead? Does he plead guilty or not guilty?
Not guilty, Your Honesty.
I hardly think that the word honesty applied to this court should cause such unseemly mirth. If there's a repetition, the court will be clear. Young man, you may address the court as sir.
Yes, sir.
You may be seated, officer. Do I understand you to plead not guilty?
Yes, sir.
This officer says that you and your friends were violating an ordinance, destroying civic property by picking flowers in the public park.
Some was picking. I was not.
Have you any proof?
Only what I say, what my friends would say.
Well, where are your friends?
They don't come. They don't want to lose day's pay, so they send fine to you with Fixer.
Why didn't you do that?
Because I am not guilty. If guilty, I admit. But if not guilty, no man gonna make me say I am. It's just as big lie to say guilty when not, as to say innocent when do something wrong.
How long have you been in the United States?
4 months, 2 days.
Ever been in court here before?
Oh, no, sir.
Where are you from?
From Kartli, his province in Georgia.
Ever been in trouble at home? Ever committed a theft, assault and battery, murder?
No, sir. No do theft or murder. I don't know about other thing. Don't know what means what you say. And battery.
Assault is threatening someone with a weapon or your fist. Battery is hitting someone, beating him up.
Battery, I did. I knocked out man's teeth once. Only a few.
Why?
He give poison food to my dog. I catched him.
Well, that's understandable. Only time?
Yes, sir.
Come forward, officer. Did you actually see this man picking the flowers?
No, Your Honor, I didn't, but...
Officer, I believe this man is a truthful man. And this time, you were probably mistaken. Case dismissed.
Thank you very much, sir.
Court adjourned at 2 o'clock.
Court's adjourned till 2 o'clock. Young man.
Young man, I'd like to shake hands with you. You've been a breath of fresh air in this court this morning. Good luck to you.
Thank you very much, sir.
I'd like to shake your hand, too.
Oh, it's great pleasure. Thank you. Thank you.
When I heard you tell the judge you were from Kartli, my ears did that.
You was in Kartli?
Oh, no. I collect folk music as a hobby, and I picked up a couple of things from Ossetia and Kefsuria.
Oh, Kefsuria is close by. It's in mountains. In half day, I could be in Kefsuria.
But I haven't got anything from Kartli, and I was wondering... You have such a nice speaking voice. I was wondering... Do you sing, I hope?
No.
Not even a little bit?
Well, a little bit. But I just sing songs only Kartlians would be interested in. These songs I learned from my father and his father.
But that's exactly what I mean.
But it's not real songs. It's only songs that people from my village make up.
Only? That's the kind of folk music collectors travel 1,000 miles to get.
Oh, well, if that is kind of music you are looking for, I know many songs, many songs. But it's not written down on paper. I just play on the guitar.
You play a guitar, too? You know, you might be the biggest discovery since the Comstock Lode. Now, look, I have a recording machine. Do you know what a recording machine is?
No.
It's like a phonograph record.
Oh.
Well, if sometime you'd have a free evening, I'd appreciate it if you'd come over and do some recording for me.
I could help.
Good. I'll give you my address and phone number.
Name, too, please.
I'm sorry. I'm Helen Watson.
Georgi Papashvili.
Excuse me for being so informal and forward, but that's the nature of the beast. Goes with collecting folk songs. We're all a little touched and rather brash. I think we'd break in or out of prison to get 8 bars or something new.
Thank you very much for a kind invitation. It's made me very happy to accept. And now, excuse me for being forward. But is tonight too soon?
Perfect. I've got a couple of other collectors coming over. About 8 or 8:30?
It's a great pleasure. Thank you. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
I look all right?
Very handsome sight.
Goodbye, good luck.
Thank you.
Good luck. And when you come back, drop in into our room and tell us what happened. Yes.
No matter how late, we'll wait for you.
Goodbye.
Good luck.
You really think she like?
With your suit, Pedro's shirt, Tonda's shoes, and my tie, she cannot help but fall in love with us.
Goodbye. Good luck.
Really.
For you.
Oh, how lovely. Thank you very much. Won't you come in?
Thank you. Sorry, it was not very good. This thing is scaring me.
Oh, don't worry. It scares everybody at first.
He's got eyes keep looking on me like so. And he keeps saying, you sing bad, you sing bad, you sing bad.
No, no, you don't.
You sing beautifully.
Of course you do.
But I think we'll get a better balance on the guitar if I move this back a bit. What are you looking for?
The tape you made at the International Club that night.
Oh, here it is.
Put it on.
Why?
No, I've got a sneaking suspicion I've heard that song before. Remember the old fellow who was so frightened? Well, that's what he sang.
Oh, no, his was much more sprightly.
No, just a different tempo, that's all.
Mr. Papashvili, are there two versions of this song? I mean, do people sing it different ways?
There may be a song can sing when happy or sad. Depend on how you look on it.
Well, now you listen to this, Mr. Papashvili. See if it isn't the same song.
Who is going to sing? Is Georgian?
I don't know what he is. He was so frightened, he barely got the song out.
Where do you find him?
There's a club in town here called the International Club. And every once in a while, they have an evening of folk songs.
And, of course, Helen barges right in with her machine.
I like to corner the people who are not on the program.
He's singing?
No, I'm just running a dog. Ah, here it is. Now it's not going to bite you. That's it. But don't stand so far away. There, that's fine. Now just forget it's there and sing.
I told you it was the same song.
Siavano, il mevar Georgi. Rozziamo per il Davide. Sadahar.
What's the matter?
Uncle John is Uncle John. Siavano is Uncle
John.
That's
your uncle?
He's not really uncle, but his family long dead, so he uncle to everybody. I look for him since first day in USA. Look. The same man?
I think that's the one. Jane, come here. Look, is this the same man?
It looks like him, but he was older than that. He had white hair.
Oh, it's a long time ago since this picture. This place where you find this man, where is?
The International Club.
It's on 58th Street between 5th and 6th. He works there as a chef.
Chef? It's Uncle John. He best cook in whole world. Excuse me, please. Got to find right away.
Boy, you coming back?
Oh, yes, yes. I come back. Excuse, please, for going so quick. When I come back, I sing songs for you. Many, many songs. All songs. I'm very sorry to go. When I come back, I bring Uncle John. He cooked best meal in whole world for you. We have banquet. Goodbye.
When?
Oh, excuse, please. Thank you very much. Goodbye. Siavano.
Biggio, Gogi!
Siavano,
Gogi! Siavano,
almeno non ti rodi più che porni di...
Dove sta l'America,
sì? Sono qui a Razzacava, lasciamo il daghese!
Now, here we are. That's Anna's house.
You sure it's all right for me to live here?
Oh, in Anna's house is always room. That's how she lives. Sticks in rumors.
Uncle John, you feel all right?
Nothing but get old. Sometimes hard to breathe. May ever thou be victorious when thou shalt stand in battle before thy enemy.
Gagi Marjos.
Welcome to new home. Now come in, come in. Anna, Chancho!
John, please, it's maybe sleeping all these
oh,
people.
Oh, they are in kitchen helping Chancho making box lunches. Two men who worked for him quit yesterday. Now, how do you like your new home?
It's very nice.
Anna, Chancho, Luba.
What is happening?
Anna.
Uncle Jack, what is happening?
That's my old friend Georgi Papashvili.
Oh.
I told you about him. Now I find him.
Georgi Papashvili, you are welcome to my home. I'm Anna Gogidze, one-time actress with famous Grodno Repertory Theater playing in all the capitals of Europe. But no more.
Oh,
this is my husband, Tariel, and this is my daughter.
Just a moment, yeah? Did you ever take a trip on ship by name Abkhazia? No. It was flagship of Southern Merchant Fleet. And I was captain of Abkhazia for many years. I'm very glad to meet you.
Glad later. And this is my daughter, Luba.
Lucy's my name.
I'm very honored, Lucy.
If you know someone who wants to learn piano, Madame Graciani teaches upstairs and downstairs. She is a widow. Very sad for a beautiful girl so young not to have husband.
How do you do?
How do you do?
I now present old friend of my father, Iliko Tornevili.
You write in, please. Your name, your father's name, when you are born, where...
Don't worry. Every Georgian who comes here gets the same treatment.
Iliko keeps record of all Georgians in USA.
He's the same to the Georgians as City Hall is to New York. Who dies, who gets born, who gets married. It's all in that book. I'll get it.
Please. Iliko, he can do it in the morning. We have so much to talk about.
All right, but if he dies in the middle of night, there is no record.
I'm Chancho. I do not keep records, play piano or captain boat. Just make box lunches.
I am very pleased.
Anna, I asked my friend Georgi to come here and live.
Of course. Where else should he live?
I am very grateful. I have also a friend by name Nuri Bey. He's come with me on boat. He's got room for him here too?
If he's friend of yours, he is welcome to my home.
He will be very happy.
And we will be happy.
Could you please be happy in kitchen? Must fix box lunches.
Chancho is right. Must finish. All come in kitchen.
Hey, Chancho.
Come on. Uh-huh.
Uncle Iliko, it's for you, Western Union. I better get the wine ready.
Chancho. Huh? Georgi and his friend Nuri Bey work all day on tar. It's no good sticking feet, sticky nose. Yesterday your helpers leave. Maybe you give them jobs in box lunches, hmm?
I could use, but I don't know how to make box lunch.
Oh, easy, I assure you.
He's so good looking.
It's so many.
He sells 300 a day.
To people who don't like their stomachs, sandwiches. Sandwiches is to eating like telephone book is to reading.
Luba, get wine, please.
It's already poured.
I just received a telegram from Flint, Michigan. Today is born to Zakara and Melusha Maskarashvili a baby boy.
Oh, very wonderful.
His relatives, this couple?
None of us ever saw him. They're just names in his record book. This goes on all the time. Every time some Georgian gets married or somebody gets born.
Luba, you will please show more respect.
May this child never want for friend, or let friends want. Ganut squete la ne la mi, chica heli helga dadis, datu lumbashis tma griales, ala verdi, ala verdi.
How
Hello.
Hello, come in.
Sorry to be late.
Oh, that's all right.
Uncle John wants very much to come, but don't feel so good, so I bring...
So I'm coming in his place to cook dinner. Very good cook, too. Happy to make acquaintance. Name is Nuri Bey. How are you? Where is kitchen?
I'm sorry about Uncle John. How do you do? I'm fine. The kitchen's right this way.
I'm going to cook for you Hünkar Beendi. It's very fine Turkish dish.
I thought we were going to have shashlik.
Well, so did I.
Shashlik is for every day. Hünkar Beendi is for party.
What is it? How do you make it?
First, you take 1 dozen eggplants.
What?
1 dozen? Nuri Bey, where do you learn to cook?
In Turkish army. You haven't got 1 dozen eggplant? Should always have eggplant. It's important, like salt and pepper. All right, we make dolma instead. You have grape leaves. No grape leaves.
I know it's careless of me, but... No.
Nuri Bey, look. Man forgot to put in garlic.
No garlic? Cannot have meal without garlic.
No.
It's like fire without flame. I go get, huh? You take bone from lamb, huh?
I will take. Here is garlic. Now we start shashlik before he come back. No man who is cooked for army is gonna cook for me, unless I am in army. Oh, is all right to use?
Certainly. Now, let's see what you'll need. You've got the lamb.
Please, could I have a knife?
Oh, yes, here it is.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, Uncle John couldn't come.
Uncle John, sorry too. But next week you come to house and he cook banquet. You bring machine, everybody sings to you.
It's a date. To tell you the truth, if I hadn't been invited, I was going to ask. That I couldn't miss.
It's not right everybody sing to you. Everybody sing for you. That's right?
That's perfect.
Hey, so hard sometimes I think I never learn.
Oh, stop it. You're doing amazingly well. You know, I'd hate to listen to an American speaking your language after only 5 months.
I would like to speak like you are speaking. It's different from New York kind of speaking.
I'm from California.
You got family there?
Just my grandmother and aunt left. They live in Pasadena.
Is no one else there? I mean, no,
No one else. You know something? Besides eggplants and grape leaves, I forgot to buy wine. Oh, you're a darling. Well, what can I do to help? Shall I light the broiler?
Not yet.
Oh, please let me. I can't wait to use it. It's brand new. I finally talked the landlord into buying it. It's really streamlined, isn't it?
So why should be streamlined stove? He's not got to go on road 60 miles an hour. He's not got to fly in air. He's staying right here in kitchen, so why should we streamline?
Oh, sir, you don't have any sharp corners.
You know, I think men who make this stove hate women. Look where his oven. Look where his broiler.
But all stoves are like that.
Only since streamline. Women who cook have to stand on head to look inside broiler. How many women you think is in USA?
I don't know, about 80 million, I guess.
So we say 40 million is little girl or eat in restaurant or get somebody cook for them. This leave another 40 million who is gonna use stoves, huh?
I guess so.
Now, from this 40 million, we say 20 million is gonna have children sometime in life, yes?
Yes.
All right. Now, what is first thing doctor say to lady who is going to have baby? Don't bend down. Look where his oven and broiler. After got children, come back trouble. Look where his oven and broiler. Should be here. Stove should be for woman who cook, not acrobat.
Oh, come now, it's not that bad.
Well, maybe not. Can't light broiler now, please. Well, how you like?
It's ambrosia.
Got to admit, it's very good. What do you call such things?
King Kali. Should be whole meal, but just make few tonight, so you can taste.
I thought the shashlik couldn't be beat, but I'll vote for this.
Yorgi, just good idea will make for us lots of money. Think over. In USA, what's everyone doing all the time, huh? Eating. If not eating, chewing gum. To fool themselves, they are eating. So we go in business making Kali.
That's not such a good idea.
Must be a good idea. I think up. It's simple. If Helen likes, so will all Americans. After a while, we'll take place of hot dogs. We drink. To Nuri Bey, Papashvili, King Kali Company.
Gargindo coro
Oh, that's the best one yet. You must be dead. I've really given you a workout tonight.
It's nothing. It's great pleasure.
Well, I really appreciate it. You're a darling for doing it.
And now, no doubts. You would like to hear me sing, huh?
Well, if you don't mind.
I'll be glad to. I'm enjoying very much to sing. Of course, voice is not what it used to be, but it's still very nice to listen to.
You want guitar?
No, just voice.
When I turn it on, you just tell what the song's all about and then go right into it.
Here is Nuri Bey, going to sing for you Kishere, his love song, very sweet, very romantic. Close by Istanbul is beautiful lake. Boy and girl are in small boat. It is such a night that comes only once in whole lifetime. It's springtime. Moon is like silver dish in sky. Water is quiet. Boy and girl look each other. Boy put arm around girl. Put heads together. And in her ear, he sings. Kishelinza Clarina, ten burudum hei, kishenoda da Clara, atas kondon hei, kishelinza Clarina, ten burudum hei, kishenoda da Clara, atas kondon hei.
Good night, thanks again.
Really
wonderful.
Thank you very
good
much.
Night. Good night.
Nuri Bey, the word darling is very affectionate word, is it not?
Very, very affectionate.
Twice tonight she called me darling.
You call her darling back?
Oh, no.
Georgi, why do you act like boys delivering groceries? Go and tell her how you feel for her.
There.
Georgi. I told you many times, don't make us of small in own eyes. You're a very attractive fellow. And I know Helen has great feeling for you.
Are you sure?
Georgi, if there is one thing I know all about, is women. In first place, she called you darling. This is word people only use when in love. In second place, it's her eyes. I can tell by way she look at you, you're living in her heart.
Nuri Bey.
You know what she's going to do in 2 minutes? She's listening to your voice and machine singing. Hoping you're beside her. This is what she's going to do. I know.
Georgi! Georgi!
At 2 o'clock, we both supposed to be here for work. No lunches tomorrow, but got to fold boxes.
When we could job with Tar and ask for money, what did boss tell us, huh?
Come back on Saturday.
What day is today?
Saturday.
All right, well, go and get our money.
Please give me mine. I want to buy a present for Helen. It's coming her birthday on Monday.
Also get something else. Big order.
But more box lunches?
No. I go to hotel with sample of King Kali.
King Kali.
Chef tastes. Mmm, he says. It's delicious. It's different. It's French chef. I tell him about our company, that we have large factory, big fleet of trucks. He's very impressed. Tonight he's having big banquet. He's giving me big order. Must be ready by 7 o'clock.
Can't do tonight. He's got banquet here at 9 o'clock. He's coming Helen. Uncle John quit job early so he can cook.
We'll be through by 6 o'clock.
But Nuribe, King Kali take time. Got to get flour and yeast.
Don't have to. I'll make arrangement with bakery. Here is address. By the time you get there, Duff will be wrapped in package waiting for you.
Duff?
It's flour and yeast for King Kali.
That thought was called dough.
It's pronounced Duff.
Uncle John say dough.
Georgi, I know he's a great friend of yours, but Uncle John don't speak English so good. Better you learn from me. He's Duff. Show you why. When meat is hard to eat, it's called tough. How you spell?
T-O-U-G-H.
Right. When ocean is up and down, it's called rough. How you spell?
R-O-U-G-H.
Right. And flour and yeast for King Kali is spelled D-O-U-G-H. So, is duff.
Duff.
Of course. Ah, oh, it's amazing how easy is language for me. I guess I must have natural leanings.
Have you got life? Henry, are you crazy? There's enough meat there for 500 King Kali.
They must get more.
More?
Order is for 50 dozen, 600. It's big banquet.
50 dozen?
We make lots of money, partner.
Henry, are you in King Kali business alone? It's your idea. I never say I go in. 50 dozen.
Georgi. Whether you like or not, you are in business. Your money I get from Tar Company is already paid for half meat and duff.
Nuribe, you got no right to do such thing. This money was for buy present for Helen.
That's why I do. So you have more money to buy better present. Don't you see? I'm doing you big favor.
All right, I go get duff.
Good, hurry up.
Nuribe.
Yes.
You do me one more favor, please.
Of course.
Starting tomorrow, don't do me no more favor.
Bang, 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 bang.
It's all right. Thank you.
Duff, his package of duff for making Cali.
You're a foreigner, aren't you?
In U.S. I am, yes, madam.
It's a bomb!
It's a bomb, it's duff. Not bomb, it's duff.
Don't get excited.
Only excited.
Let me out of here.
Already 4 o'clock. Still no Georgi, still no Duff. Georgi, where are you?
Don't ask questions, just take.
Now we drink to Georgi Papashvili, who is 5 months in America today.
Get up, Georgi. Get up.
I see American faces here tonight, and I like to tell them I am pleased to see them at this party, because I have honor now for 5 months to be at their table. That big table, which is USA. And I enjoy all things which is put before me. I see also here Greek and Georgian, and Syrian. And sitting in the same room and eating the same food is even Turk and Armenian. And I say to myself, if in USA such a thing can happen, then here anything can happen.
Bravo.
It was a beautiful speech, Georgi.
I should have had the recording machine going for that.
You are very kind. I want to say something about how I wish for a time when I become citizen.
Well, that's not so far off. In about 4.5 years, you'll be a full-fledged American, eating hot dogs, rooting for the Giants.
He's a good American now.
Of course he is. I only meant that in a little while he'd become a citizen, like you and me.
I'm not a citizen.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought...
Just because a man is not able to vote, does not mean he's not as good as men who can.
Who said anything
Uncle
about...
Uncle John, why you never become citizen?
Because I was born at Cartlian and I stay Cartlian.
I'm sorry. He's not like Uncle John to act so.
But what did I do? I just said someday you'd be rooting for the Giants. I guess he must be a Yankee fan. Well, this I've got to find out about.
No. I talk to him tomorrow and smooth things over.
Look, George, as for myself, it doesn't make any difference how he feels. But I know how important he is to you, and I don't want to be the reason for any strain between you two.
Helen, not now.
Georgi, what's the matter? I saw Helen...
The two people I want more than anything to like each other. I've got to fight.
Is it something I said, or is it just me you don't like?
Leave me alone, please.
Oh, no, not until you give me some idea.
It's nothing, nothing.
Oh, come now. You don't stalk out of a house for nothing.
What kind of... I say to myself, no, it's finished. I insult her, she cry, go home, never speak to me again. Instead, you come right out and ask me what the matter. What kind of a woman are you?
Well, what kind of a man are you? I make an innocent remark, you jump down my throat and run out of the house. Did I say something to offend you?
No, no, it's not you. It's me. You see, Georgi was very young when we meet, and he looked up to me like father. And he thinks I'm a very wise man, and I hate to disappoint, but I'm a very stupid man. And when you talked about being citizen, it came all back to me.
Did you have some trouble with your citizenship?
When I came to this country, I want more than anything in the world to be citizen of the USA. Right away, I got first papers. For 5 years, I studied, learned all the name of presidents and everything. And then I went for examination, and you know what happens?
What?
George Washington, Abraham Lincoln, everybody is leaving my head. I did not pass examination. I am disgraced.
But you could have tried again.
Wait. I study some more. I go back. I am outside the room where many Swiss ask questions. Walking up and down, seeing answers to myself, and everything is fine. And then they call my name, and suddenly I begin to shake, and everything get mixed up, and now it's George Lincoln, Abraham Philadelphia, and Benjamin Declaration. I go home and never come back. That's where I am still, Cartlian.
You were just nervous. I bet I could make you pass that test.
How?
By coaching you, by going to the examiner with you and not letting you get scared.
You would do such a thing?
Of course I would.
Oh, you are a real friend. Please, don't tell Georgi. I warned him that he shall be frightened by examination.
I promise I won't.
Thank you.
You better come in. Western Union called again.
Now come. You see.
I just received a telegram from Pittsburgh. Chakra Babuzzi. Chakra Babuzzi is dead today. Not married.
Sorry. I was thinking of wedding.
I call meeting to talk about our friend Georgi Papashvili. It's very serious.
What is happening to Georgi?
He's sick.
I take care of him. I was nurse to my husband for 2 years before he died.
Sit down. That's not that kind of sickness. That's here.
And who is he enjoying this sickness with?
Helen.
That is bad.
Bad?
Better he was in love with Georgian lady, like Madame Grisciani.
Mama.
Madame Grisciani is too old.
Dariel, how can you say such a thing? She is cousin of my uncle, so is your flesh and blood. So my own husband would say a thing. You think she is too old?
Oh, no. Just think Georgi is too young.
Anna is right. Should be Georgian lady. Now I have here in Cleveland, Ohio, a Georgian girl by the name Pilona Gazuri. Daughter of Datico. She's young, beautiful, is very good cook, and...
What's wrong with American lady?
American ladies are wrong in three places. First place, American ladies don't like to have foreigner names. I know a Georgian man by the name of Tex Valashvili who married an American girl. She makes him go into court and change his name to Thomas Dewey. In election, Thomas Dewey don't win. Uh-huh. How do you think he feels then, this Georgian fellow?
And after Dewey lose twice, he changed name back to Pekshvalishvili.
And what do you think it does to my record book?
Second place, American ladies cook only from book. Who gets lost, husband? Stop!
Helen is very good cook.
And I will teach her Georgian dishes.
Third place is Babgets.
Babgets?
Babgets means writing money down before you are spending.
Mama, you mean budgets.
Babgets is this. If tomorrow Georgi is wanting to drink glass of wine, yesterday he has to write in book, I am drinking wine, 25 cents.
Wait a minute. I find here another Georgian girl in Denver. Make very good wife. Come from beautiful family, is 26 years old, and the best cook in the whole book.
But he loves Helen. He don't love good cook in Denver.
But how does he know? He's never seen her.
Georgi.
Yes, Uncle John.
Come in.
But I was going out.
First you are coming in.
Good evening.
All your friends here talked about you and reached important decision.
I have not reached.
Do not interrupt. We decided you should engage yourself to Helen. Quick, tonight.
Uncle John would like very much to engage myself, but I think he's too fast.
Georgi, in USA, everything is fast. Lady and gentleman meet on Saturday, have date on Sunday, marry Monday.
Oh, but Helen is not such a person.
Oh, so now you're expert, eh? Believe me, if there is one thing I know all about, is American women. Show you where you're over 100% wrong. Helen hasn't seen you lately, huh?
Tonight she sees me.
What happened the last three times you asked her for dinner?
She was busy.
And why was she busy? Because you never once say something romantic to her. She's not a girl from school. She's at the age where she's looking for a husband. Unless you say something to her quick, she'll find some other man who will.
But how can I ask Helen to marry me? I have nothing.
And is she a queen in a castle with $1 million? No. She's an ordinary girl who works in court on a machine. And you are an ordinary man who works making box lunches. So you marry.
I would like very much, Uncle John, but I don't
think... Enough talk. You like, we like, it's finished. Now go. And when you are engaged, come back with Helen. And I will cook big banquet for celebration.
But go.
Now everybody in kitchen, we make banquet.
Oh, hello, oh, George. Helen, come in. I was going to call you, but I've been busy talking to every airline in town.
Well, Helen, what?
My aunt phoned about an hour ago. My grandmother just had a stroke.
Oh, that's...
I've got a seat on a plane. I've got to hurry. I've only got 45 minutes.
Helen, I'm awful sorry.
Well, even though she's 76, and you know it's got to happen someday, still when it does, it's... She and I have been awfully close. My parents died when I was a kid. She raised me.
I hope when you get there, she is much better.
Well, the doctors don't promise much.
Is there anything I can do to help you get ready?
No, I'm all packed. I was just waiting for you. Let me see. Mrs. Parker, clean out the icebox and turn off the gas.
Will she water the ivy?
Oh, she might not. Would you take care of it for me, dear? I wouldn't want it to die.
I take good care.
I hate to go, but if I don't, I'll never make it.
You don't want to leave?
I never thought I'd mind. I suddenly find out I do. I guess when you get attached to a place and certain people, you... Well, here, I'll take this. You'll carry the suitcases. Oh,
okay. You got everything?
I think so.
Would you like for me to come to plane with you?
I'd love it, George, but there won't be a minute to spare, and then you'd have that long trip back from LaGuardia. And after all, I'll be back soon.
How long are you going to be gone?
Well, Well, it all depends, of course, but I should guess about 2 weeks. Well, goodbye, George. Take good care of yourself. LaGuardia, please.
Charge of belief for Mr. Spencer. Now remember, he likes just a touch of garlic.
All right, all right, all right.
I'm glad you quit Bachstrand's business. You are best vegetable man I ever see.
I have to quit, it's only fair. Chancho was not getting money's worth from me. He got too many things on my mind.
Georgi, I must give you advice. Helen said she will be away for 2 weeks. All right, now you have 2 months, but you got to stop acting so. You are like clock without ticking it.
But let us say she don't know when she is coming back now. Maybe not for a long time. Grandmother is not better, is not worse.
Well, it's only one thing to do. We go to California. I got money saved up.
Thank you, but could not let you do it. If you don't get a job is one thing, but you got good job here.
Good job.
Just a touch of garlic.
That's how I made chahoch, Billy. Since you don't like, I quit. Now I have no more job. I think I go to California. Would you like to come along?
I dreamed to go to California, and now comes through my dream. When we go?
We? Go just Georg and me.
And leave Luba and me behind? We must go. How can Luba become a moving picture star if she does not go to Hollywood? It's impossible.
Well, since we're in New York, we start from here.
You are part of the wish he's talking about?
Of course. When I was captain of Abkhazia, I sailed every one of the seven seas. In all kinds of weather, and I was never once off the course. And why? Because I'm an expert navigator. I'll take compass with me. California is west. So I look at compass and keep us in right direction. And we take only roads going west. It's very simple if you know how.
Tariel, it's not necessary. Uncle John and me, we go by bus. Driver can take us.
No, more practical idea. To all put money in pot and buy car.
Right. When we come to Chicago, I'll find here shortcuts. Saves much time.
Wait a minute. Anna, it's not possible, your idea. Say we buy car, and in it we put Uncle John, you, me, Luba, Tariel. It's five. Where goes all suitcase?
Where goes all suitcase? They go in Chancho's truck.
Chancho goes too?
Of course. He just sell box lunch business to Nuri Bey.
Anna, must be practical. You cannot just walk from house. You got lease.
It's all arranged. Madame Grisciani takes over. Nuri Bey hires your friend for box lunch business and they stay here. Also, I have two more friends who move in.
Now I have in California.
I suppose you come too.
No, I stay. Get too many letters, telegram. It's too much trouble writing everybody, changing address. But when you come to California, I have a second cousin by name Besso. He live near a place by name Azusa. He has a very big farm there. And here is his address.
Good. We all go see him.
No, we do not all go see him, just Georgi and me. Finished letter. Going everybody is too much trouble.
All right, girl. Leave behind good friends. Leave me to freeze in cold winters. Like when we have big snow, and I'm struggling through snow, pile up to my waist. But leave me. After all, who am I? Nothing but good friend who opens doors of her house to you when you are poor and have no place else to go.
Also is coming Anna, Luba, Teriel, and Chancho. Wait till you meet this crew. They're completely mad and utterly charming.
What are they coming for?
Well, my guess is that they were all sitting around the living room one rainy day, and Anna remarked that rain depressed her, so Teriel said, let's go to California. Everybody else said, why not?
Oh, Helen.
I mean it. They're completely unpredictable. You should see the way they whip up a banquet at the slightest provocation.
Well, when a man drives 3,000 miles, it's usually to get to someplace or somebody. You're sure you're not the reason he's coming out?
Oh, of course not. See, it's going to
and
be
you're sure to... you're not in love with him?
Those green pills are going to your head.
Well, what's so funny about it?
Well, I don't know, but
he's a man, isn't he?
And a very honest, considerate, sweet one. But he somehow doesn't strike one as being, well...
And after all, Mother, he's been in this country less than a year. Why, he isn't even a citizen.
Well, this may come as a big surprise to you, Florence, but the glands are not controlled by second papers.
Listen to this. He's going to be tight fit, but we put all the baggage in Chancho's truck.
Very tired. You want me to drive?
No!
Stop!
What's the matter?
An accident.
We're going in the wrong direction. It's impossible. Signs say Highway 66.
California is west. Compass says north is there, so we're going south.
It's because road make turn.
But if California is west, why does road go south?
Maybe there was a lake or something in the way.
There was another road back there that goes straight.
It was dirt road. Man say take Highway 66, so I stay on 66.
It's big mistake. Should only go on roads going west. That way make shortcuts.
Shortcuts, huh? Shortcuts.
George Washington, John Adams, Thomas Jefferson, James Madison, James Monroe. George Washington, John Adams, Thomas Jefferson.
How did you get here?
By taking road that goes west.
You and your compass.
Daniel, stop! He's only making it worse.
The chain truck would pull out if you had chain.
Sancho, you go that way, I go this way. Maybe we find help.
And you could not stay on main road. No. You've got to take shortcuts. So we end up in middle of boiling desert. You take away that thing. You think it's funny, huh? Well, you wait. This is what is going to happen to all of us. We'll all die here from starving, and when they find us, we'll be just like that. Skeletons.
Skeletons.
And why? Because you've got to steer car like a boat.
You must treat them with great respect. They are first citizens of the USA.
They have captured Georgi, and they are coming now to kill us by taking the skin from our heads.
Oh, Mama, stop it.
Don't be afraid, Anna. Mother. Don't be afraid. Mother. I will not let them touch you. I have a knife. Before I die, I kill you and Pluba. I was captain of Hardy.
Mother Chemo.
The mutiny. I had the knife.
Mother Chemo.
Shut up,
Mother Chemo Gwishwale.
Look, Sign! He's only 12 miles away. Look at Big Sign!
Azusa, Daria, look!
Azusa? This place where Bessel, Ilika's cousin, lives.
Oh.
Since we're here, Papa, why don't we go to this place first?
Oh, no, we go to Helen first.
Wait a minute! Ilika's cousin is Georgian. He will have banquet, and I am hungry.
We can eat later. First, we go to Helen.
All right, girl. Have your own pleasure. That I am starving is not important. After all, who am I? I am nobody. Just something in the back seat. Something like another suitcase. Something that has no feeling. No stomachs. You are right to be paid no attention.
Azusa.
Because after all, who am I? I am robbery.
Such a house.
I once acted in a play that had house just like this. Some very nice people, I am one of them, are coming to house and are going in, but are never coming out.
What happens to them?
They're all dead from being murdered.
Looks like there's nobody home.
In such a house like this, if anybody is home, he shouldn't be.
And what is this thing? Maybe it was ghost.
Miss Minecaro, Vincenzo Gangas Gizia, Mamma Mizida, Papa Mizid Gizia Biharian, me Armin Ayeti Cartelis, Keles and Mosplats.
What'd you say?
I'm not talking to him. I'm talking to Dor. I'm saying, listen, Dor, whoever is standing behind you is crazy, and his father was crazy, and his grandfather was crazy, and I am not going to his funeral.
Gagi Marcius. If you excuse me, please come into my house.
No, you go first.
I take it back about your father and your grandfather, but I still think you are crazy. Why do you, a Georgian, keep people out of the house?
I don't want to know nobody. I want everybody to go away, leave me alone. I'm miser.
Then why do you let us in at all?
When I hear your voice, I split in half. I don't know what to do. Turn away my countrymen, let you go, and say ever after, I knocked the door of Besso, but door stayed closed against me. I would have no face left, so I'll let you in. Please come in.
I suppose the explanation is you was Georgian first before you started being miser.
I suppose. Please sit down on broken chairs.
My name is Georgi Papashvili, and this is Uncle John, and over there is Chancho, and this is Anna Gogice, and Lyuba Gogice, and Pariel Gogice.
Did I ever take a trip on ship by name Abkhazia?
Oh, it was... sit down.
We are sent to you by your cousin, Ilika.
Oh, Ilika must be a very nice name. He writes me you are coming. He writes me many letters and tells me what Georgian is living where. But I do not answer because writing paper is costing money.
You are first Georgian I ever met who do not like company. Most times we are too much the other way.
If I am acquainted with people, they borrow from me. So I make rule. Don't see people.
You want we should go?
No. As long as you are here, might as well stay.
Why, you want to be miser? Are you having pleasure from being?
How can one have pleasure in house like this?
Then why you let house get like this?
And trees, why you let weeds choke them up?
Land is not good.
If I had such farm...
You like to buy?
Where I get such money?
I lend it to you. I always hope to find buyer. But since I do not like to meet people, I never have chance to sell.
Why do you want to sell?
One day I find newspaper on the road. Somebody throw from car. And I read, in state of Nevada, there is places where is nobody for 50 miles. Want to go and live right in the middle of such 50 miles.
How much you want for this farm?
What does it matter if I'm lending you the money?
Well, I want to know.
Well, we'll talk later. Now I take you to your rooms. Ladies.
After I take one look at house, I know the thoughts I'm thinking are thoughts of crazy men. If I worked for 100 years, I could not buy her such home. Uncle John, there is only one thing to do. We got to go away from here. We go to San Francisco, any place.
But you just bought far from best, so.
I have not bought yet. I said I would like to own such a farm, but I did not buy. Besto!
Georgi, to marry in the USA is not how much you got. How much you love. It's not like in our village in Kartli, where woodcutter can only marry daughter of other woodcutter.
But Uncle John, man who cuts grass on such place makes more money than I could. It's no use to argue. I got mind made up.
You want me?
Oh, Besto, I find out just now I cannot buy farm. As gentlemen, I beg of you, please, to tear up paper.
Georgi, I admit I'm gentleman, but I'm also miser. Gentleman, he me says, tear up paper. But miser says, it would be very bad business. And since I'm more miser than gentleman, I must hold you to your handshake.
Besto is crazy. I never shake hands to buy farm.
Georg, it's better so. If you run away now, maybe all your life you will regret. There's no law says you must ask her to marry right away. First buy farm, then you will own a piece of America. Then you can hold your head high. And you have perfect right to ask anybody to marry.
But Uncle John...
If you still feel the same later, no harm is done. Now, Do me another favor. Go see Helen and take her ivy plant. Even she's no more than friend. You must see her. Just make sociable visit. Say nothing about marrying. Now go.
I
go.
Certainly taking good care of this, George. It looks like Jack's beanstalk.
I don't do nothing special. Just let it grow.
You mean you brought that thing all the way from New York?
Well, was room on truck, so just bring along.
Oh, how's Nuri Bay and Illico?
They just fine. You miss New York, Helen?
Oh, I did it first, but I got a job now.
Oh, with machine?
Taking depositions, minutes of meetings.
And what about you, young man? Is this a pleasure trip, business, or what?
Well, Uncle John decided he wanted to go to California, and then I decided to go with him, and then others decided to go with us. He's very Georgian. In my country, he's saying, to keep a friend company, a Georgian once hanged himself.
Well, now that you're here, do you intend to settle?
Well, don't know yet. Thought maybe we'd go to San Francisco, but Besso, his Ilika's cousin, has got place at Azusa where we are staying. And he wants I should buy his farm.
Out here we call them ranches, partner. What kind of a ranch is it?
Run down. Well, it's got few orange trees.
Well, now you're talking my language. That's what my husband did.
Oh.
This whole block was known as Watson's Grove before we subdivided.
Must have been very big farm, ranch.
Yeah, but we started with only 2 acres. That was in 1904.
1905?
1904. We left Scotland in September 1903. You were 4 months old. We stayed 6 months in Cleveland and came out in 1904.
You mean you and your husband was immigrants?
And my husband was just about as old as you when he came.
Some more tea, George?
No, thank you. I've got to go now. All the others are waiting. Well, goodbye. It's very nice to meet you.
Pardon my left hand, but my right one doesn't seem to belong to me lately. Goodbye. And don't be a stranger around here. I like you.
Thank you very much. Goodbye.
He wrote to Illico and told him he bought a rundown farm. So Illico wrote to all Georgians in California and ordered them to come down and bring friends this Sunday to help Georgie fix up.
So they come from Fresno, San Diego, Bakersfield. Must be 2 dozen.
What are you, the supervisor?
No, I want to work, but they won't let me.
If he works, he starts panting like a dog.
I got a letter from government to come for citizen examination on Wednesday.
Are you ready?
Washington, Adams, Jefferson, Madison, Monroe, other Adam, Jackson.
You're ready. I'll pick you up Wednesday morning. Where's George?
Out in orange trees.
Oh, they sure look healthy now.
Well, they should. George works 18, 20 hours a day.
The house is going to look beautiful.
Wouldn't you be proud to live in such a house?
I sure would.
You see? That's what I tell Georgie. To hear you say that would make Georgie... Excuse me, will you?
What did she mean by that?
Nothing.
Remember me? I'm the girl who keeps asking until she finds out.
Oh, this Anna, such a mouth. Well, you probably guessed a long time ago anyway, so it won't be such a surprise. When Georgi gets everything finished, he's going to ask you to marry with him. It is a surprise.
Yes. Not a little one.
You don't feel the same?
I wish I did, Uncle John, but I just...
Someone else?
No.
Are you sure?
I said no.
But you said no as I said nothing. I'm also the kind of person who keep asking until he finds out.
There was someone. That's why I went to New York, trying to get over it. I think I did. I don't know. It was just like this, one of these one-sided affairs. I was completely in love with him, and I thought he felt the same.
Why do such things have to happen to people I've liked? You tell him now.
Uncle John, these things are never easy, but the longer you wait, the more it hurts.
Well, it's good to see you.
You're digging it too far from the tree.
I wish Grandma was here. The government book don't say what to do about these kind of branches.
Oh, that's from fertilizing with too much nitrate of soda. Just prune the dead branches and tar the stumps.
You know, too?
Until I was 14, I didn't know there was another kind of tree but an orange.
Well, what do you think of farm, Reg? You like the way he's coming along?
Oh, it certainly looks 1,000% better, but Uncle John says you're working too hard.
Well, I got something to show you. Look what I got yesterday. Is bill for taxes. Just think, I'm in this country less than a year, and already I owe for land tax. It's great progress, no?
It certainly is, and I'm very happy for you, George. But
you know, sometimes I wake up in the middle of the night and I think to myself, in village where I come from, on a ranch farm, one quarter so big as this, a man can raise a family and send children to school and have golden watch with golden chain. And such a farm is mine.
George, there's something I...
Oh, Helen, there's something else I want to show you.
Hey, Vichibo! Mami! Vichibo, Shabbat! Vichibo, Vichibo! Daulio!
Uncle John, Helen knows more about oranges than government. I think we'd throw Book away and keep her instead. Well, I got to wash hands. I'll meet you inside.
You didn't tell him?
I couldn't. Not now. I tried, but he's so enthusiastic about this place.
Maybe it's better we don't tell him all at once. Nick, little by little. That way doesn't hurt so much. I can find time now and then to say small things, make him be prepared for it.
Would you, Uncle John?
Sure. Now, come. Go in.
I want to drink my thanks to all of you who come here today to help fix up this house. But more, we are here to say goodbye and to drink health of Besso, who goes tonight to Nevada. Besso, we got present for you.
Has lock on it, so inside you can keep your money.
We drink to Besso. Everybody drink to Besso.
Besso, Tornare!
Besso!
Wait!
Before you drink, I have something to say. I'm not going.
But by tonight, house will be all fixed up. There is no more reason for you to stay.
But this house is investment for me. And the miser must stay close to his investment, otherwise he's not good miser.
But I send you $50 every month.
That's what you say now. But maybe if I'm far away in Nevada, you try to cheat me and don't send. No. I stay and make sure you pay.
We drink anyway. To Besso, the most generous miser I ever know. And the man who liked nothing better than to live alone. With lots of company. Besso, Besso, Rasbonikos.
Ucvenodromi, Korzine.
George has gone to get the doctor. Just take it easy. You're going to be all right.
Washington. Adams. Jefferson. I know all answers. I wanted very much to die a citizen. No, it's too late.
No, it's not, Uncle John. I know a judge. He's a friend of the family. You hold on. I'll be right back.
And now, who was the first president of the United States?
George Washington, father of country.
Why did the original English settlers first come to America?
For the same reason I came. To be free. Free to pray in own church. Free to be equal with other peoples. Also, it's a very fine place to live.
Who called a republic a government of the people, by the people, for the people?
Was Abraham Lincoln. A very upstanding American.
What is the largest river in the United States?
Miss. No help from audience, please. I know answer. It's Mississippi. And I take this obligation freely.
And without any mental reservation.
And without any mental reservation.
Or purpose of evasion.
Or purpose of evasion.
So help me God.
So help me God.
By the power vested in me, I pronounce you a citizen of the United States of America.
Congratulations, Uncle John.
You do very well. Very well.
Please, no more talking. Let him rest now.
No. I said before, if I only can become citizen, I won't mind to die. No, I want to vote.
You will too, don't worry.
Please, doctor, you're a very fine man, but in time like this, I would like best friends should hold my hands. Makes easier. Good time. Good time. Helen, there is a saying in our country.
While you were out getting that tree, Mr. Papashvili called.
You told me then.
Did I? See how I'm losing my memory? Did I tell you he called this afternoon, too?
Yes, and I wish you'd stop goading me. I know what he wants. He wants me to have dinner with him. If I do, I'll have to tell him.
Isn't that more kind than just not answering?
Don't you think he's been through enough the past couple of weeks with a funeral and...
You don't want to see him. Not because you'll have to say no, but because you might say yes.
But I've told you and told you and...
That he doesn't give you that chill up and down your spine. Oh, that you can get from a cold shower. And that you've had. And what did it give you? Two of the coldest years you've ever known. And even if Fred hadn't walked out on you, it would have been wrong. He didn't need you. And that's the only basis for a marriage. To be needed and wanted. And not only in marriage, in just everyday living. A person that somebody doesn't need and want is awfully lonely.
Can't you ever talk about anything else?
Florence. Stupid of us. There she sits and we talk about...
That's one of the penalties of being silent and 50. People begin treating you like furniture. And watch out, young lady. You're well on the way to becoming a straight-back chair yourself.
But don't you understand? I've got to be certain this time. I know he loves me, but we're 1,000 miles apart in 1,000 different ways.
Well, what worries me is not whether it's this man or not, but whether you'll ever let yourself be in love with any man again.
Not until I'm sure. Until I am, I'm not going to get emotionally involved.
Unless you do, you can't begin to be sure.
Well, at least you don't get hurt.
That's what Florence said years ago. And come to think of it, she never has been hurt since. Oh, crank me down, dear, before you go. And
we now take you to the office of the Fruit Frost Service at Pomona for the frost warnings.
Good evening. Following are the lowest temperature estimates for California citrus areas. Azusa District. Azusa 26.
Freeze tonight, eh? Little early. What did he say Azusa would be?
26.
Has George ever thought of freeze before?
No.
Oh, well, he's got a lot of help out there.
You call that help? They'll probably... bring the smudge pots in the kitchen and cook a banquet on them.
Don't get excited. They're not your oranges.
I told him to get experienced help, but no, no, he could do it. Well, we'll find out. Tomorrow he's going to have 10 acres of rotten oranges.
Dress warm. You might get a chill.
You've got your pots too spread out. Helen, get some more in here.
How you know that?
Get them on the northeast side of the tree.
What?
You should have started this 2 hours ago. I told you to get some help, but no, no, you can do it by yourself.
But Book said that freeze don't begin until January.
What's the temperature?
20.
Oh, get the pots!
But Book said...
I don't care what the book says. Get the pots!
But Helen, listen to me from...
Will you get the pots?
It's too cold here. We should go back to the house and have hot coffee.
What's this supposed to be, a family reunion? Get some more pots in here. And another oil drum.
But
well, don't stand there. Get going. Do you want George to lose all his trees?
What's the temperature?
37.
I'm
I'm tired like dead cow.
Never in my whole life did I ever realize there is so much work in one glass of orange juice.
I'm sorry I gave you such a rough time of it, but at least we managed to save most of them. Well, I guess we all could stand a little sleep. Goodbye.
Bye.
Helen, I had big plans to make this far ranch like your grandfather's. And when it was so, I was going to ask you to marry with me.
George,
please let me finish first. All night long I'm practicing. If I stop now, I get all mixed up. Now I think perhaps to wait is not the best idea. If it is going to be a good ranch, we should make it so together. Because marriage is a living thing, and it should grow like a tree.
George.
Please, I have nothing that I can offer you now, except this place, which is not paid for. But every room is filled with love for you. I need you, Helen. Just like a man who...
Can I say one word now? Yes.
You mean you would marry with me now?
You know why? Because I need you a lot more than you need me.
Remember how we were. I come back in just a minute.
Petras!
Hey!
Hello!
How are you? Look marvelous!
Why is it so smoky?
It's the smudge pots for orange Georgie. Trees. Nuribe, why you don't write and say you are coming?
We drive all night to get here.
Madame Grisciani!
No longer Madame Grisciani. I'm Madame Nuribe now.
Helen, come look and see what happened.
I know. We make banquet.
Go inside. Say hello to Helen. Nuribe, what do you think? Just this minute, Helen says she is going to marry with me.
It's no surprise. I tell you, first time you meet her, Helen is very much in love with you. Georgie, if there is one thing I know all about, is women.